and they gave me a heart attack. G'day, didgeridoo, smart person. My name's Dylan. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Welcome to the Physics Club, where we science the shit out of everything. You're probably getting sick of these, but I had to do it because we just hit 20K subscribers. So thank you so much to everyone who has subscribed. And if you haven't already, what are you doing with your life? Subscribe. No, but don't worry, there won't be any more of these for a while because subs are slowing and I am running out. I did only buy a pack of 50. And funny story, I actually bought them for a birthday surprise. I woke someone up with one of these for their birthday. Today we're going to react to The Mandalorian. I myself am a big Star Wars geek, so I thought we could break down some of the physics of The Mandalorian. You won't find any serious physics here, but you will find some seriously fun facts, so keep an open mind. Obviously, we're going to discuss whether or not lightsabers could be a real thing, but I'm going to save that for the end of the video, so make sure you stick around for that. And of course, we're going to start with the Force. Not every day you see rhinos float. Baby Yoda. So cute. That's why they're an endangered species. Alright, so is there something in physics that resembles the Force? Particularly in, say, quantum mechanics? I know what you're thinking. Can objects from a distance be manipulated spontaneously? Answers modern physics may have. Currently, we only know of four fundamental forces, two of which are nuclear, then there's the electromagnetic field and the gravitational field. All of which play a role in binding together matter, from the smallest of atoms to the largest of planets. Now, in this next bit, I might use a few buzz terms, so if you don't know what they mean, I highly encourage you to Google them. But there is this mysterious thing in physics where you can link two particles, you can separate them over a long distance, and you can observe the effects of one upon the other. This is known as quantum entanglement. It's where two particles share the same quantum state. And it's when you bring them close enough together, their wave functions, I'm not going to explain what that is, you can Google it, they overlap and they form sort of one wave function. And this quantum entanglement stuff is far weirder than anything George Lucas has ever dreamed up. So George Lucas was actually heavily influenced by quantum theory. His whole idea of the Force somewhat resembles it. In the early 60s and 70s, it was proposed that this quantum entanglement really is a force that binds us all together. And it is well known that the observer can become entangled with whatever they are measuring, which affects the measurement. This is probably what led George to the conclusion that everything is entangled in this weird way, and that there really is a connection between every living thing in the galaxy. What about the Force as an energy field created by all living things? Well, physicists are only just starting to study quantum stuff in biology, and it's forming a new area of biology known as quantum biology. There is actually some evidence that processes in large biomolecules might actually be influenced by quantum mechanical effects. And there are some newer ideas being proposed that microtubules might have some quantum mechanical behavior that's influencing its behavior as well. The odds at the moment, however, do seem low that, you know, quantum stuff does play a role in life. However, as Han Solo would say, never tell me the odds.
Dropping out of hyperspace now.
So, this hyperspace stuff, is it possible? Well, in theoretical physics, of course it is. The idea of hyperspace is based on the presumption that there is a separate region of space-time beyond the four dimensions which we currently are aware of. Maybe in these other dimensions, time is indiscrete and jumps around from point to point, which allows, say, a ship to achieve movement without any real velocity. Maybe these other dimensions have different physics, ones where ships' propulsions might have compounded effects. Maybe the speed of light ain't shit. So I'm sure you've all heard of wormholes, which is kind of what we're talking about, right? If something allows, me to get from one point to another faster than the speed of light through some hidden dimension, that's kind of what we think of as a wormhole. And if it wasn't already obvious, it should be clear that this hyperspace travel is not at the speed of light. Speed of light is 300,000 kilometers per second, which sounds mighty fast, but in the broader scale of things, it's really not. It takes a long time for light to get from one star to the other, for example. But in Star Wars, they jump around, and it takes them no time at all. So this hyperspace travel, what we're talking about, is something far beyond the speed of light. So how realistic are these hidden dimensions? Well, I'm sure you've probably heard of string theory, and there's many variations of string theory currently. The leading one of which is called M theory, and it posits there's 11 dimensions. Whether they're these small, tiny dimensions that are wrapped up and we can't see them, or there really are these large hidden dimensions. Well, string theory is already a bit of a long shot. There's currently no evidence for it. So yeah, there could be these hidden dimensions around us where we could get from point A to point B much quicker than if you were traveling through space itself in our currently known four dimensions. Alright, so Jedi versus Mando. So Jedi's got a lightsaber, and Mando's got Beskar steel. Now, I want to talk about, is there really a metal that could withstand a lightsaber? A lightsaber is meant to be the plasma, right? I'm fairly sure. And is there a metal that could withstand such temperatures? Well, plasma is what you find on the sun. Is there any metals we know of that can withstand that sort of temperature? Currently, no. Is there a metal theoretically that could withstand such temperatures? Not really either, as far as I know. So if anyone knows better, please comment down below if you know of such materials. But that sort of temperature, yes, will turn most things to liquid metal. So this Ahsoka, this Jedi, is an alien species. Looks like she's got an octopus on her head or something. I shouldn't say that, probably gonna be called like an alien racist or something, right? But could there be aliens like this roaming out there in the I don't mean Jedi, I mean ones that look like Ahsoka, right? And yeah, if the universe is infinite, there probably are aliens out there that look just like her. I mean, if you gave octopus some space, like if humans disappeared and we gave octopi a few million years, they could end up looking like this. I'm kidding. Obviously, they're not gonna look like a human and an octopi, yeah, right? But what I'm saying is, if we gave octopi some time, they very well could develop sentience. Have you ever seen that Netflix documentary, My Octopus Teacher? If you haven't, I will leave a link in the description to the trailer. It's really incredible. I will never eat another octopus. So, could there be something like this guy? A somewhat sentient robot? Of course, I could. I mean, consciousness is obviously some kind of phenomena we don't currently understand, but we're all experiencing it, so I have no doubt that it will be it we can explain it and it will be explainable. And when we happen to get there, I have no idea when we're going to make some inroads in that on that, but you can imagine that we could do stuff with it, like put it in a robot, right? But yeah. So, Lightsabers, the magnetically confined plasma. Are they a possibility? Well, certainly not if it's magnetically confined plasma. That just doesn't work. That you throw that one in the bin. You know, we're trying to create fusion reactors by magnetically confining plasma. And in a lightsaber that you hold, and it does not seem like a possible thing to do. So yes or no? I say yes and no. I say yes because we still know very little about the universe and all its mysteries, and there could be things that we discover in the future that allow us to create a lightsaber, honestly. But I also say no. When you see Jedi fight, their lightsabers bounce off each other. So if you really had a lightsaber that was made of plasma or light, it wouldn't really do that. They would go straight through each other, and it's like if you had two lasers and you went like that, they're not gonna stop each other, are they? But there were some experiments conducted in 2013 that showed it was possible to actually bounce light off each other, bounce photons off each other. So maybe with a few more discoveries, you know, we might realize there is a way to have a lightsaber duel, but I don't think it's very likely.
We need to talk.
I hope it's about him.
Baby Yoda. Love me some Baby Yoda. What about Baby Yoda's age? He's a species that apparently lives to at least 900, right? I mean, Yoda was meant to be about 900. So is that possible? Could there be aliens out there living for 1,000 years? I think yes. I think obviously it's very possible. Take a look around us, and you've got blue whales in the ocean living for who knows how long. I'm pretty sure we found blue whales with like old like harpoons in them, and we were able to date the harpoons on them to like 200, 180 years old, I believe. And then there are things like the Greenland shark, which I can't remember. I think it's like 300 years we've dated them to. So, and then there are those fungi forests, which I think lived something like in the range of thousands of years. I can't remember if it was 25,000 or 10. I know, I think it was 10,000 years. So you could, I think one can easily imagine some sort of species out there that does live for a lot longer than us. And imagine if they arrived at our doorstep, right? And this species lives for 10,000 years. Imagine what they'd think of us, you know, living for less than 100 on average. They'd think we're like ants. You know, they'd probably step on us like we step on an ant and think, you know, what could these beings possibly learn within 100 years? You know, they're as good as ants. We may as well step on them. Things like butterflies, right? You know, a butterfly, there's like four stages of life for those things, right? And the final stage is the butterfly, and there are some butterflies that live for like a day. So I guess we're like the butterflies to some alien species out there, probably. It reminds me of that Carl Sagan quote. We're like butterflies who live for a day and think it's forever. And on that note, I might end this video, and I'll catch you guys next time. Don't forget to subscribe.